Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over what a one-to-many relationship is.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
So here we are back in our contacts database that we've been slowly building throughout our access lessons. And right here is a table called contacts. If I double click this table, I can see that I have several different fields in here for first name, last name, middle initial, etc. But over here, I have a contact type. And I formatted this field as a drop-down box. I'll include the link in the video below to show you how we created this combo box. But when I click this, I see a list. And this list of values comes from a table over here called contact types. So if I double click on that, I can see all these types: work, school, family, friend, music. If I close that, those are the identical values right here for work, school, family, friend, music. So in this case, every single one of my contacts has one type of contact. So down here, if I change this to work for Jen, I can see that both John and Jen, while these are different contacts, they have the same contact type. So it's possible for many different contacts to have the same contact type. So if I wanted to see this relationship in picture format, I see my contact table over here and my contact types over here. So there is many different contacts could have one of these contact types. So if you see this infinity sign right here on this side of the relationship, that is the many side of the relationship. And this is the one side of the relationship. One important thing to note when you're creating a many-to-one relationship is that this field on the many side has to be the same data type as this field on the one side. So let me show you that. If I right click on contacts and go to design view, my contact type here is a number, and down here I can see it's a long integer. And if I right click on my contact types and go to design view, when I look at my contact type ID, I can see that that is an auto number, and down here it's also a long integer. If these data types are not the same, you will not be able to create a relationship on these fields.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
So going back to our relationships view right here, you can see that in the contact types table, this is the primary key of this table. And this field right here on the many side of the relationship, this is what's known as a foreign key. So if it's the ID of the table, it's the primary key. If it's a field that's pointing to the ID of another table, that is called the foreign key. In case you're curious how I get to the relationships view that I was just showing you, I'm going to go up to Database Tools and go to Relationships. And once I'm in here, I can drag any table in my Access database into here. So I'm just going to click Contacts with my left mouse button, and I'm going to drag into here. And I can resize this. So if I move the mouse around and I get this double-headed arrow, if I hold my left mouse button down, I can drag this and make it bigger. I can also click with my left mouse button on contact types and drag that into here as well. And to create a relationship on different fields in my tables, all I have to do is click the one field on the left side and drag it over to the right side. And this box will automatically appear, and it will show me the assumed relationship type is a one-to-many. So if I click Create, I can see that this relationship is automatically created, and this will be useful later on when you want to create queries and join your tables. If you double-click on the relationship, there's a thing here called Enforce Referential Integrity, and what that means is that the data in the contact type in the contacts table has to have a valid number that's in the contact types table. So if I click that and say okay, you will see the one to many signs appearing in here. And that only happens when I click enforce referential integrity. So hopefully that gives you a good introduction as to what a one-to-many relationship is, as well as the terms of primary key and foreign key. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.